Great Inventors by David Angus, read by Benjamin Soames. People have always tended to think of inventors as a bit odd, and the popular view of a crackpot, a mad professor, or an absent-minded dreamer has been reinforced by some of the most wonderful characters in fiction, from Count Frankenstein and his terrifying monster to Caractacus Potts and his flying car. There is an element of truth in all this. What marks out inventors is their ability to see things differently from everybody else, so naturally they are apt to be a bit eccentric. They also tend to be people who concentrate so hard on the problems that they want to solve that they can seem to be a bit absent-minded to the rest of us. The ancient Greek inventor Archimedes was sometimes so absorbed by his calculations that his servants would wash him and dress him without his appearing even to notice them. John Logie Baird, the inventor of television, when he was accused of being absent-minded, tapped his head and replied, "I'm present-minded in here. I'm only absent-minded on the outside." So invention can often be a rather lonely, even secretive business. Perhaps the greatest example of this can be found in the work of the 15th century Italian artist Leonardo da Vinci. Leonardo is most famous for his magnificent paintings, such as The Last Supper and the Mona Lisa. But when he died, his notebooks were discovered to contain, as well as sketches, the most astonishing technical drawings of completely original inventions, some of them ideas for machines that would not be developed for hundreds of years. Certainly, in his own lifetime, nobody could have taken them very seriously, and Leonardo made his notes in a code that he'd invented called mirror writing, so that only he could read them. He made detailed drawings of a tank powered by horses, a parachute, a machine gun, a hang glider, a diving suit, a bicycle, and even a sort of helicopter. There wasn't the scientific knowledge in Leonardo's lifetime to have made any of these machines work, but all of them have been reinvented since. Invention is not quite the same thing as science. Scientific research often throws up new discoveries, sometimes quite by accident, but these are discoveries of things that already exist in nature. An inventor is someone who makes something that is entirely new, and sometimes inventions can actually change the world. Of course, science and invention may go hand in hand. A discovery by a scientist can inspire an inventor to turn it into something practically useful. Black powder, which was discovered in China in the middle of the 8th century, was the result of mixing different substances in an attempt to make a medicine or elixir for eternal life. But when they discovered that it exploded when ignited, it wasn't long before an inventor used it to make a weapon. When black powder arrived in Europe in the Middle Ages, it led to the invention of all kinds of different weapons and, later, to the development of the first engines. Occasionally, scientists have been inventors themselves. But throughout history, inventors have tended to be people outside the established scientific world, and often they've had to fight against the doubt and even the ridicule of scientists. So inventors tend to be secretive about their ideas until they can prove that they work. But there is another, even more pressing reason for secrecy. For a good idea to be turned into a practical invention, it usually takes a great deal of time, effort, and money. There has always been an argument between those who think that new inventions should be shared freely with other people and those that believe that they should be able to make a profit from their own ideas. It's fair to say that the most famous inventors who argued that all inventions should be shared, Archimedes and Benjamin Franklin, were both wealthy enough not to have needed to make a profit from their work. At any rate, today, nearly every country in the world has laws, known as patents, that protect the profits made from new inventions for the inventor for up to 20 years. In the past, this was not always the case, and, as we shall see, some famous inventors spent more of their lives trying to protect their inventions than they ever did in making them work.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.